नमस्कार विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो, याच्या अगोदरच्या व्हिडिओमध्ये आपण इयत्ता 11वीच्या पाठ्यपुस्तकातील पहिल्या धड्याच्या आईस ब्रेकरच्या ॲक्टिव्हिटी पाहिलेल्या आहेत आणि आजच्या पाठामध्ये आपण पाहणार आहोत या धड्याचं इंग्रजीमध्ये वाचन तसेच इंग्लिशमध्ये स्पष्टीकरण. चला तर मग सुरुवातीला आपण बीइंग नेबरली या पाठाच्या ज्या लेखिक आहेत लुईसा मे अल्कॉट या लेखिकेचा परिचय पाहूया. लुईसा मे अल्कॉट 1832 to 1888 एन अमेरिकन रायटर इन द मिड टू लेट 19th सेंचुरी इज कन्सिडर्ड ॲज वन ऑफ द अर्लिएस्ट फेमिनिस्ट रायटर्स. आउट ऑफ द सेव्हरल बुक्स शी रोट हर सिरीज बिगिनिंग विथ लिटल वुमन हॅज बीन ह्यूजली पॉप्युलर अमंग द मासेस अँड क्रिटिक्स अलाईक फॉर अ सेंचुरी अँड अ हाफ. हर सिंपल स्टाईल अँड लाहिवली कॅरेक्टर्स हॅव लेफ्ट अ मार्क अँड इन्फ्लुएन्स्ड जनरेशन्स ऑफ चिल्ड्रन अँड अडल्ट्स अलाईक. द सेटिंग ऑफ हर बुक इज द सबर्ब्स ऑफ बोस्टन. हर वर्ल्ड व्यू इज होलसम अँड फुल ऑफ बिलिव्हेबल ॲट चार्मिंग कॅरेक्टर्स विच कॅप्टिवेट्स द रीडर्स. द फॉलोइंग एक्स्ट्रॅक्ट इज फ्रॉम लिटल वुमेन फर्स्ट पब्लिश्ड इन 1868. धिस स्टोरी ऑफ फोर सिस्टर्स मेक जो बेथ and Amie, their friends Laurie, their wise and loving parents of modest means, living in a suburb of a city in the east coast of America, has caught the imagination of generations of readers, young and old alike. Each character's is real and distinctive. We remain firmly with the sisters through all their struggles, conflicts, triumphs, and joys. It serves as guiding light to us in all the phases of our lives. The extract affords us a tantalizing glimpse into the book and narrates the beginning of a lifelong friendship between Joe, the brightest and loveliest of four sisters, and Laurie, their wealthy new neighbor. The March girls and Laurie become best buddies and much more as book progresses. आता आपण धड्याचं लाईन टू लाईन रीडिंग करूया. धडा संपूर्ण वाचूया. धड्याचं नाव आहे बीइंग नेबरली. व्हॉट इन द वर्ल्ड आर यू डूइंग टू डू नाऊ जो, आस्क्ड मेग वन स्नोवी आफ्टरनून ॲज हर सिस्टर केम ट्रॅम्पिंग थ्रू द हॉल इन रबर बूट्स ओल्ड स्कॉक्स अँड हुड विथ अ ब्रूम इन वन हँड अँड अ शॉल in other. Going out for exercise, answered Joe with a mischievous twinkle in her eyes. I should think two long walks this morning would have been enough. It is cold and dull out, and I advise you to stay warm and dry by the fire, as I do, said Meg with shiver. Never take advice. Can't keep still all day, and not being a pussy cat, I don't like to doze by the fire. I like adventures, and I'm going to find some. Meg went back to toast her feet and read. I won't know एंड जो बिगेन टू डिग पाथ्स विद ग्रेट एनर्जी द स्नो वॉज लाइट एंड विथ हर ब्रूम सी सून स्वेप्ट अ पाथ ऑल राउंड द गार्डन फॉर बेथ टू वॉक इन व्हेन द सन केम आउट एंड इनवैलिड डॉल्स नीडेड एयर नाउ द गार्डन सेपरेटेड माचेस हाउस फ्रॉम दैट ऑफ मिस्टर लॉरेंस बोथ स्टूड इन अ सबर्ब ऑफ द सिटी विच वॉज स्टिल कंट्री लाइक विथ ग्रोज एंड लॉन्स लार्ज गार्डन्स एंड क्वाइट स्ट्रीट्स अ लो हेज पार्टेड द टू एस्टेट्स वन ऑन वन साइड वॉज एन ओल्ड ब्राउन हाउस लुकिंग रादर बेयर एंड शैबी रॉब्ड ऑफ द वाइन्स दैट इन समर कवर्ड इट्स वॉल एंड द फ्लावर्स विच देन सराउंडेड इट ऑन द अदर साइड वॉज अ स्टेटली स्टोन मैंशन प्लेनली बेटोकनिंग एवरी सॉर्ट ऑफ कंफर्ट एंड लग्जरी फ्रॉम द बिग कोच हाउस एंड वेल केप्ड ग्राउंड्स टू द कंजर्वेटरी एंड ग्लिम्सेस ऑफ लवली थिंग्स वन कॉर्ड बिटवीन द रिच कर्टेन्स येट इट सीम्ड अ लोनली लाइफलेस सॉर्ट ऑफ हाउस फॉर नो चिल्ड्रन फॉर लीक्ड ऑन द लॉन नो मदरली फेस एवर स्माइल्ड एट द विंडोज एंड फ्यू पीपल वेंट इन एंड आउट एक्सेप्ट द ओल्ड जेंटलमन एंड हिज ग्रैंडसन टू जॉर्ज लाइवली फैंसी दिस फाइन हाउस सीम्ड अ काइंड ऑफ एन्चेंटेड पैलेस फुल ऑफ स्प्लेंडर्स एंड डिलाइट्स विच नो वन एंजॉयड सी हैड लॉन्ग वॉन्टेड टू बिहोल्ड दीज हिडन ग्लोरीज एंड टू नो द लॉरेंस बॉय हु लुक्ड एज इफ ही वुड लाइक टू बी नोन इफ ही ओनली न्यू हाउ टू बिगिन सिंस द पार्टी सी हैड बीन मोर एगर दैन एवर एंड हैड प्लैन्ड मेनी वेज ऑफ मेकिंग फ्रेंड्स विथ हिम बट ही हैड नॉट बीन सीन लेटली एंड जो बिगैन टू थिंक ही हैड गॉन अवे व्हेन सी वन डे स्पाइड अ ब्राउन फेस एट एन अपर विंडो लुकिंग विस्टफुली डाउन इंटू देयर गार्डन वेयर बेथ एंड एमी वेयर स्नो बॉलिंग वन अनदर That boy is suffering for society and fun, she said to herself. His grandpa does not know what is good for him and keeps him shut up all alone. He needs a party of jolly boys to play with or somebody young and lively. I have a great mind to go over and tell the old gentleman so. The idea amused Joe, who liked to do daring things and was always scandalizing Meg by her queer performances. The plan of going over was not forgotten. And when the snowy afternoon came, Joe resolved to try what could be done. She saw Mr. Lawrence drive off and then sailed out to dig her वे डाउन टू द हेज वेयर सी पॉज्ड एंड टुक अ सर्वे. ऑल क्वाइट कर्टेन्स डाउन एट द लोअर विंडोज सर्वेंट्स आउट ऑफ साइट एंड नथिंग ह्यूमन विजिबल बट अ कर्ली ब्लैक हेड लीनिंग ऑन अ थीन हैंड एट द अपर विंडो. देयर ही इज थॉट जो पुअर बॉय ऑल अलोन एंड सिक दिस डिसमल डे. इट इज द सेम I shall toss up a snowball and make him look out and then say a kind word to him. Up went a handful of soft snow and a head turned at once, showing a face which lost its listless look in a minute. As the big eyes brightened and the mouth began to smile. Joe nodded and laughed and flourished her broom as she called out. How do? Are you sick? Laurie opened the window and croaked out as hoarsely as a raven. Better. Thank you. I have had a bad cold and been shut up a week. I'm sorry. What do you amuse yourself with? Nothing. It's as dull as Tom's up here. Don't you read? Not much. They don't let me. Can't somebody read to you? Grandpa does sometimes, but my books don't interest him, and I hate to ask Brooke all the time. Have someone come and see you then? There isn't anyone I would like to see. Boys make such a row, and my head is weak. Isn't there some nice girl who would read and amuse you? Girls are quiet and like to play nurse. Don't know any. You know us. Began Joe. Then laughed and stopped. So I do. Will you come please? Cried Laurie. I'm not quite a nice, but I'll come if mother will let me. I'll go ask her. Shut the window like a good boy and wait till I come. With that, Jo shuddered her broom and marched into the house, wondering what they would all say to her. Laurie was in a flutter of excitement at the idea of having company and flew about to get ready for, as Mrs. March said, he was a little gentleman and did honor to the coming guest by brushing his curly pate, putting on a fresh color and trying to tidy up the room, which in spite of half a dozen servants was anything but neat. Presently there came a loud ring, then a decided voice asking for Mr. Laurie, and a surprised looking servant came running up to announce a young lady. All right, show her up. It's Miss Jo, said Laurie, going to door of his little parlor to meet Jo, who appeared looking rosy and quite at her ease with a covered dish in one hand and base three kittens in the other. "Here I am, bag and baggage," she said briskly. Mother sent her love and was glad if I could do anything for you. Meg wanted me to bring some of her blancmange. She makes it very nicely, and Beth thought her cats would be comforting. "I knew you would laugh at them, but I couldn't refuse." She was so anxious to do anything. It so happened that Beth's funny loan was just the thing for in laughing over the kids. Laurie forgot his bashfulness and grew sociable at once. "That looks too pretty to eat," he said, smiling with pleasure. As Joe uncovered the dish and showed the blank mangs surrounded by a garland of green leaves and the scarlet flowers of Yummy's pet geranium. "It isn't anything," only they all felt kindly and wanted to show it. "Tell the girl to put it away for your tea. It is so simple, you can eat it, and being soft, it will slip down without hurting your sore throat. What a cozy room this is." It might be if it was kept nice, but the maids are lazy and I don't know how to make them mind. It worries me though. "I'll write it up in 2 minutes, for it only needs to have the hearth brushed so and the things made straight on the mantelpiece so and the books put here and the bottles here and your sofa turned from the light and the pillows plumped up a bit. Now then you are fixed." And so he was, for as she laughed and talked, Joe had whisked things into place and given quite a different air to the room. Laurie watched her in respectful silence, and when she beckoned him to his sofa, he sat down with a sigh of satisfaction, saying gracefully, "How kind you are. Yes, that's what it wanted. Now please take the big chair and let me do something to amuse my company." "No, I came to amuse you. Shall I read aloud?" And Joe looked affectionately towards some inviting books nearby. "Thank you. I have read all those, and if you don't mind, I would rather talk," answered Laurie. "Not a bit. I shall talk all day if you will only set me going. Beth says I never know when to stop. Is Beth the rosy one who stays at home good deal and sometimes goes out with a little basket and asked Lori with interest. Yes, that's Beth. She is my girl and a regular good one she is too. The pretty one is Meg and the curly haired one is Yummy, I believe. How did you find that out? Lori colored up but answered frankly, why you see, I often hear you calling to one another and when I am alone up here, I can't help looking over at your house. You always seem to be having such good times. I beg your pardon for being so rude, but sometimes you forget to put down the curtain at the window where the floors are. And when the lamps are lighted, it is like looking at a picture to see the fire. And you all around the table with your mother. Her face is right opposite and it looks so sweet behind the flowers. I can't help watching it. I haven't got any mother, you know. And Lori poked the fire to hide a little twitching of the lips that he could not control. The solitary, hungry look in his eyes went straight to Jo's warm heart. She had been so simply taught that there was no nonsense in her head. And at 15, she was as innocent, as frank as any child. Lori was sick and lonely and feeling how rich she was in home and happiness, she gladly tried to share it with him. Her face was very friendly and her sharp voice unusually gentle as she said, we'll never draw that curtain anymore and I give you leave to look as much as you like. I just wish, though, instead of peeping, you would come over and see us. Mother is so splendid. She would do you heaps of good. And Beth would sing to you if I begged her to, and Amy would dance. Meg and I would make you laugh over our funny stage properties and we would have jolly times. Wouldn't your grandpa let you? I think he would if your mother asked him. He is very kind, though he does not look so, as he lets me to do what I like. Pretty much, only she is afraid I might be a bother to strangers, began Lori, brightening more and more. We are not strangers, we are neighbors, and you needn't think you would be a bother. We want to know you, and I have been trying to do it this ever so long. We haven't been here a great while. You know, बट वी हैव गॉट अक्वेंटेड विथ ऑल आवर नेबर्स बट यू. यू सी ग्रैंडपा लिव्स अमंग हिज बुक्स एंड डजंट माइंड मच वॉट हैपन्स आउटसाइड. मिस्टर ब्रूक, माय ट्विटर डजंट स्टे हियर यू नो एंड आई हैव नो वन टू गो अबाउट विथ मी सो आई जस्ट स्टॉप एट होम एंड गेट ऑन एज आई कैन. दैट्स बैड. यू ऑट टू मेक एन एफर्ट एंड गो विजिटिंग एवरीवेयर यू आर आस्क्ड. देन यू विल हैव प्लेंटी ऑफ फ्रेंड्स एंड प्लेजेंट प्लेसेस टू गो टू. नेवर माइंड बीइंग बैशफुल. इट वोंट लास्ट लॉन्ग इफ यू कीप गोइंग. लॉरी टर्न्ड रेड अगेन बट वाजंट ऑफेंडेड एट बीइंग अक्यूज्ड ऑफ बैशफुलनेस फॉर देयर वॉज सो मच गुड विल इन जो. इट वॉज इम्पॉसिबल नॉट टू टेक हर ब्लंट स्पीचेस एज काइंडली एज दे वेयर मींट. डू यू लाइक यूर स्कूल आस्क्ड द बॉय चेंजिंग द सब्जेक्ट आफ्टर अ लिटल पॉज ड्यूरिंग विच ही स्टेयर्ड एट द फायर एंड जो लुक्ड अबाउट हर वेल प्लीज्ड. डोंट गो टू स्कूल आई एम बिजनेसमैन गर्ल आई मीन आई गो टू वेट ऑन माई ग्रेट आंट एंड अ डियर ड्रेस क्रॉस ओल्ड साउल सी इज टू. आंसर्ड जो. लॉरी ओपन्ड हिज माउथ टू आस्क अनदर क्वेश्चन बट रिमेंबरिंग जस्ट इन टाइम दैट इट वॉजंट मैनर्स टू मेक टू मेनी एनक्वायरीज इन टू पीपल्स अफेयर्स ही शट इट अगेन एंड लुक्ड अनकंफर्टेबल. जो लाइक्ड हिज गुड ब्रीडिंग एंड डिडंट माइंड हैविंग अ लाफ एट आंट मार्च सो शी गेव हिम अ लाइवली डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ द फिजेस्टी ओल्ड लेडी हर फैट पुडल एंड पैरट दैट टॉक्ड स्पैनिश एंड लाइब्रेरी वेयर सी रिफेल्ड. लॉरी एंजॉयड दैट इमेंसली एंड व्हेन शी टोल्ड अबाउट द प्रिम ओल्ड जेंटलमैन हु केम वंस टू वू ऑन मार्च एंड इन द मिडल ऑफ अ फाइन स्पीच हाउ पोल हैड ट्विक्ड हिज वीक ऑफ टू हिज ग्रेट डिसमे द बॉय ले बैक एंड लाफ्ड टिल द tears ran down his cheeks and a mind popped her head in to see what was matter. Oh, that does me no end of good. Tell on, please. He said, talking his face out of the sofa cushion, red and shining with merriment. Much elated with her success, Jo did tell on all about their plays and plans, their hopes and fears for father and most interesting events of the little world in which the sisters lived. Then they got to talking about books, and to Joe's delight, she found that Lori loved them as well as she did and had read even more than herself. If you like them so much, come down and see ours. Grandfather is out, so you needn't be afraid, said Lori, getting up. I am not afraid of anything, returned Joe with a toss of the head. I don't believe you are, exclaimed the boy, looking at her with much admiration, though he privately thought she would have good reason to be a trifle afraid of the old gentleman if she met him in some of his moods. The atmosphere of the whole house being summer-like, Lori led the way from room to room, letting Joe stop to examine whatever struck her fancy. And so, at last they came to the library where she clapped her hands and pranced, as she always did when especially delighted. It was lined with books, and there were pictures and statues and distracting little cabinets full of coins and curiosities and sleepy hollow chairs and queer tables and bronzes and, best of all, a great open fireplace with quaint tiles all round it. What richness, sighed Joe, sinking into the depth of velour chain and gazing about her with an air of intense satisfaction. Theodore Launce, you ought to be the happiest boy in the world, she added impressively. A fellow can't live on books, said Lori, shaking his head as he perched on a table opposite. Before he could say more, a bell rang and Joe flew up, exclaiming with alarm, "Mercy me, it's your grandpa." "Well, what if it is? You are not afraid of anything, you know," returned the boy, looking wicked. "I think I am a little bit afraid of him, but I don't know why I should be. Marmy said I might come, and I don't think you are any the worse for me for it," said Joe, composing herself, though she kept her eyes on the door. "I am a great deal better for it, and ever so much obliged. I am lonely, afraid you are very tired of talking to me. It was so pleasant, I couldn't bear to drop," said Lori gratefully. "The doctor to see you, sir, and maid beckoned as she spoke. Would you mind if I left you for a minute? I suppose I must see him, said Lori. Don't mind me. I am happy as a cricket here, answered Joe. Lori went away and his guest amused herself in her own way. She was standing before a fine portrait of the old gentleman when the door opened again and without turning, she said decidedly, I am sure now that I shouldn't be afraid of him, for he is got kind eyes. Though his mouth is grim and he looks as if he had a tremendous will of his own, he isn't as handsome as my grandfather, but I like him. Thank you, ma'am, said a gruff voice behind her, and there, to her great dismay, stood old Mr. Lawrence. Poor Joe blushed, still she couldn't blush any redder, and her heart began to beat uncomfortably fast as she thought what she had said. For a minute, a wild desire to run away possessed her, but that was cowardly, and the girl would laugh at her, so she resolved to stay and get out of the scrape as she could. A second look showed her that the living eyes under the bushy eyebrows were kinder even than the painted ones, and there was a sly twinkle in them which lessened her fear a good deal. The gruff voice was gruffer than ever as the old gentleman said abruptly after the dreadful pause, so you are not afraid of me, hey? Not much, sir. And you don't think me as handsome as your grandfather? Not quite, sir. And I have got a tremendous will, have I? I only said I thought so. But you like me in spite of it? Yes, I do, sir. That answer pleased the old gentleman. He gave a short laugh, shook hands with her, and putting his finger under her chin, turned up her face, examined it gravely, and let it go, saying with a nod, you have got your grandfather's spirit. If you haven't his face, he was a fine man, my dear, but what is better? He was a brave and an honest one, and I was proud to be his friend. Thank you, sir. And Joe was quite comfortable after that, for it suited her exactly. What have you been doing to this boy of mine, hey? Was the next question sharply put. Only trying to be neighborly, sir. And Joe told हाउ हर विजिट केम अबाउट. यू थिंक ही नीड्स चीयरिंग अप अ बिट, डू यू? यस सर, ही सीम्स अ लिटिल लोनली एंड यंग फोक्स वुड गो डू हिम गुड परहैप्स. वी आर ओनली गर्ल्स बट वी शुड बी ग्लैड टू हेल्प इफ यू कुड, फॉर वी डोंट फॉरगेट द स्प्लेंडिड क्रिसमस प्रेजेंट यू सेंट अस, सेड जो ईगरली. टट टट टट, दैट वॉज द बॉयज अफेयर. हाउ इज द पुअर वुमन? डूइंग नाइसली सर. एंड ऑफ वेंट जो, टॉकिंग वेरी फास्ट एज शी टोल्ड ऑल अबाउट हर हमेल्स इन हुम हर मदर हैड इंटरेस्टेड रिचर फ्रेंड्स दैन दे वेयर. जस्ट हर फादर्स वे ऑफ डूइंग गुड. आई शैल कम एंड सी यूअर मदर सम फाइन डे. टेल हर सो देयर इज द टी बेल. वी हैव इट ईगरली ऑन द बॉयज अकाउंट. कम डाउन एंड गो ऑन बीइंग नेबरली. इफ यू वुड लाइक टू हैव मी सर, शुडंट आस्क यू इफ आई डिडंट. एंड मिस्टर लॉरेंस ऑफर्ड हर हिज आर्म विथ ओल्ड फैशन्ड कर्टसी. वॉट वुड मेक से टू दिस थॉट जो, एज सी वॉज मार्च्ड अवे व्हाइल हर आईज डांस्ड विथ फन एज सी इमेजिन्ड हरसेल्फ टेलिंग द स्टोरी एट होम. लुईसा मे अल्कॉट. विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो, या धड्यावरच्या ब्रेन स्टॉर्मिंगच्या ऍक्टिव्हिटी याच्या नंतरच्या व्हिडिओमध्ये आपण सविस्तरपणे देणार आहोत. त्याच्यामुळं याच्या नंतरच्या व्हिडिओचं नोटिफिकेशन आपल्याला लवकरात लवकर मिळावं असं वाटत असेल तर या चॅनलला लाईक करा, सबस्क्राईब करा आणि हा व्हिडिओ आपल्या जास्तीत जास्त मित्रांपर्यंत पोहोचवण्याचा प्रयत्न करा. संपूर्ण व्हिडिओ पाहिला याच्याबद्दल धन्यवाद.